In this lesson, we will learn how to install and set up the Matplotlib library. So to install Matplotlib, we will use the PyCharm ID. PyCharm provides an open source and free version, that is the community edition. So we will install Matplotlib on PyCharm and run our programs. Let us see the steps now to install Matplotlib. At first, we will download and install Python and pip. Pip is a package manager used to download, install and manage Python packages. So we will install both first, the current version in step 1. After that, in step 2, we will install the open source version of PyCharm, which is freely available, that is PyCharm Community Edition. Then in the third step, we will connect the first and second step, that is Python and PyCharm. In the fourth step, what we will do, we will run our first Python program on PyCharm to understand how PyCharm works. Then comes the last step and the key step, that is to install Matplotlib on PyCharm so that we can begin with our first Matplotlib program. So guys, let us start with the first step. To download and install the current Python and pip version, let's start. We will download and install the current Python version. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type Python and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible. Click on it, python.org. Here is the official website. Now keep the mouse cursor on downloads. Now you can see the current version, Python 3.12.0, is visible. Click on it to download. It will download. It's only 25 MB. Download completed. Now right click and click on open to start installing Python. We clicked on the exe file, minimize. Now the setup started. Herein, at first select add python.exe to path. Now click customize installation. This shows what we are installing. It will install pip also. Pip is used to download, install and manage Python packages. It will also install IDLE. IDLE is an ID to run Python programs. Now click next. Advanced option, it will install Python 3.12 for all users. It will also set the environment variables. Okay. And Python will get installed in the following location under program files. Keep it a default. You can change it from here by clicking browse. But keep it as it is. No problem. Click install. Now the installation started. Guys, we have successfully installed Python. Click close. Now let us verify the installation. Go to start, type cmd. Click open to open the command prompt. Herein type the command python space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. This shows that we successfully installed Python. Guys, we successfully installed the current Python version. Now we will install PyCharm. For that, go to the web browser. I am using Chrome. You can use any web browser. Herein type PyCharm and press enter. On pressing enter, the PyCharm is visible. It is owned by JetBrains. Click on it. Now we have reached the official website here. Now you can directly click download here, or you can also click download. Let's click. Herein you can see PyCharm Professional is visible, which is for a 30-day trial, then you need to pay. But we are going for the free version, that is the community. And here it is. You can download it from here. It is freely available and open source, so you can use it. EXE file download. Click on it. Now the download will begin. Here it is. The download started. It's only 418 MB. Let's wait. We have downloaded it. The EXE file for PyCharm. Community version, free version. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The installation started. Click next. Now it is asking wherein PyCharm will get installed. It will get installed in the following location, keep it as it is, and it will take 1.5 GB. Click next. Desktop shortcut, yes, we can create. Update context menu, you can add a folder to project so that you can directly, so that you can open any folder as project. Rest keep as it is and click next. Start menu folder, yes, click install. And now the setup will begin. The desktop shortcut also got created. Now let's wait for this to complete. We have completed the PyCharm setup. I can also select Run PyCharm Community Edition and click Finish so that it begins. But I'll only click Finish. So in this way, we can install PyCharm. Now let us open PyCharm and connect Python with PyCharm. Can also go to start and type PyCharm instead of going for the shortcut. Here it is, Community Edition, click open. Now PyCharm will open for the first time. Here in the terms are visible, I confirm, click continue. Data sharing. PyCharm opened for the first time. You can go to customize and here in select, let's say light theme or dark theme. I'll go for light theme and rest keep as it is. Go to projects, click new project. Herein you can see our project will get saved here. If you want to change the name of the project, you can change from here. Let's say I'll name it Amit project. Okay. Now you need to set the environment. It will go for the virtual environment, a new environment, which is fine. The base interpreter you need to set. It is only showing Python 3.9 and 3.10. Click on the three dots. Program files, wherein we installed Python. 3.12. Click on it. Select python.exe and click OK. Here it is, we have set Python 3.12 now. You can see we have set it. We have connected our Python with PyCharm. Okay, remove this because we are creating a sample program. Click create. Okay, here is our project. I clicked here for the menus. Okay, now this is our project, this is our environment. Now we need to add a new Python file to run our first Python program. I'll right click on Amit project, click new, and here in select Python file directly. It will automatically go for .py extension. Here in add the name of your Python file and press enter. It will create demo.py. Here it is. Now you can directly run your first project. Let's say I'll just print something. Okay, I'll go for file, save all. Right click and click run demo. Here it is, studio.pdf is visible. Okay, that means we successfully printed using the print method in Python. Here it is, studio.pdf. You can also run using run here, click run demo, or you can use shift F10 or alt plus shift plus F10. Okay, you can also increase the font by going to file, settings, here in appearance is visible, go for editor and click font. Here in the font is only 13. Let me take it to 18 and click OK. Click apply, then OK. Now the font will increase. Here it is. Even the output font is also 18 and the editor font also. With that, you can check the location also. Here it is. C users Amit underscore PyCharm projects. C users Amit underscore, that is the username. Here it is, PyCharm project, projects, Amit project. Here is a demo.py file. With that, you can also go to the file option and click settings. Okay, and select the project and the interpreter to verify again that you have set 3.12 or not for our project, and yes, we have set the same 3.12 for our project. We successfully installed Python pip and PyCharm, and we also ran a sample Python program on PyCharm. Now let us see how to install the Matplotlib library on PyCharm. So here was our project, a sample project, Amit project. So to install any library, go to File, click Settings. After clicking Settings, go to your project here and click Python Interpreter. After that, click on the plus sign to install. You can see install is visible. Click the plus sign and type the library you wish to install. I have typed Matplotlib and it is visible here. It is a Python plotting package. Click install package. Now it will install. Here package installed, package Matplotlib installed successfully. Click close. Now you can see the same is visible here, the same message and Matplotlib installed. Click OK. And that's it guys. In this way we can install Matplotlib on PyCharm. So guys, we successfully installed Python, pip, PyCharm and Matplotlib. Now we will move towards the next lessons and understand how to run our first Matplotlib program. Thank you for watching the video.